Jesus. Anybody out there? Need a little help? You're alive.
One of my lifetime ambitions is to have met
Neil Jordan.
Well, I know Neil from before. It's you. It's
Colin Farrell.
Pressure.
Hey,
how are you, man?
How are you?
Good, thanks.
I'm Irish in my background, but you know, raised very here. Irish. But I know, because yeah. I look more Irish, and you're like Black Irish.
Yeah, some Spaniards had a good time off the coast a few hundred years ago.
That's what I thought. My mother used to talk to me about Black Irish because she had dark hair and dark eyes.
It was Spanish Armada, wasn't it?
Spanish Armada,
they made their way up the West Coast and got on land and had a hooli.
Well, that's sort of what this film is about, Ondine, because you're getting something off the sea too in this. It's a mermaid, a beautiful, and oh God, I can't pronounce your
Alicja.
Name.
Alicja
Bachleda.
Yeah, close
get
enough.
Her in a net. There's a movie about, I'm just going to say it's about a mermaid, okay? I'll just put that out there. Yeah, yeah, that's a beautiful story.
Thank you. Yeah. Thank you very much.
Yeah.
it's a complete fiction. You made it all up.
Oh, yeah. No, it actually happened to me. I was out fishing one day and she was African, actually. But
There she was.
This beautiful girl, and she. I have her in a little caravan somewhere. I'm not telling you about it. No, I made it up. Yeah.
Once upon a time. And yeah. Colin, this beautiful, sensitive performance from you.
Thanks, man.
You know, but it didn't surprise me because, you know, in Tigerland, in your phone booth movies with Joel, whom I love, Schumacher above all.
Yeah, I love him.
I mean, you've shown that you've got the chops to do a dramatic, serious, you know, sort of beautiful role like this.
Right.
What's his name? It's
Syracuse.
Okay.
Otherwise known as Circus.
Yeah.
Circus, right.
The town clown.
Yeah.
Was at one stage. It was lovely, man. I just, you know, when Neil gave me the script and said, I'm thinking of doing this, just tell me how you feel about it. And I loved it. I mean, I just jumped at the opportunity to do it. I loved this character. I loved the kind of simplicity to him and his insistence on getting through life and his complete lack of self-pity. And I was kind of swept away by the more magical elements in the script as well, but never strayed too far from the kind of harshness of reality that visits people from time to time. And yeah, I loved it.
And
I mean, I'd wanted to work with Neil for 6 or 7 years, so...
Well, who doesn't want to
work with Neil? It was kind of a perfect storm, and in this part of the world, it's a perfect storm.
And it's a beautiful part of Ireland.
Oh, it's gorgeous.
It's not the part that you're from, so it's a different accent, isn't it?
Yeah, very much so. I mean, there's a pile of dialects, different dialects in Ireland, and it's quite a strong accent in this part of the world, yeah.
In West Cork, yeah.
Yeah, the West Cork accent's kind of strong.
Yeah, it's really strong.
I mean, they were talking about subtitling me at one stage.
Were they?
Yeah, I think so.
Oh,
I understood everything.
Good
perfectly.
Man.
Yes.
No, I think it's not that. You delivered the accent beautifully, actually. It's very. But we did speak at one stage. I mean, he could have been a transplanted Dubliner, couldn't he?
Yeah,
you're speaking now in what we would call a Dublin accent.
Dublin,
is
that
right? Yeah, mild Dublin accent.
Well,
it's been a while.
Mid-Atlantic Dublin, I'd say.
But you shot it around your house.
No,
I
have.
I thought that was fabulous.
Well, no.
I have a house down there, you know, and it's like, it's my wife. It's a lovely part of the world. It has a specific beauty and a specific kind of gravity to it.
Yeah.
And I thought I would love to photograph some of these places someday. And it just happened when I began to think of this story, you know, I put all the places I knew down there into this story, so it ended up being almost like functioning as a set, this little landscape, you know, so I kind of shaped the story around the landscape, really.
And you have a daughter in this film
who
is disabled, and those scenes were very beautiful, Colin, very beautiful.
They were lovely scenes on the page, they were beautiful, they were so simple and about so much, and you know, as much about the unspoken things as, and she was wonderful, Alison Barry, who played the daughter, I mean, Neil gave her such wonderful dialogue to have these kind of, you know, these grandiose thoughts come out of a child's mouth and her use of language, you know, to pull it off, I mean, it's a testament to her. I loved those scenes. They were very gentle. And there was just no tricks, no sleight of hand to a lot of the film. I mean, even how the more magical elements are dealt with, there's no special effects, no nothing. It really asks the audience to engage with them on a level that demands that they connect to their imagination or a more childlike aspect of themselves.
Well, I believe in mermaids, so it wasn't a problem, really. Being Irish is just part of the whole thing. Listen, it's so wonderful to meet Neil Jordan always and Colin Farrell for the first time.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you
very much.
Okay. Thanks, good luck with Ondine. You gotta see it.
Goodbye now.
Thanks, man.